So what I like about papier-mâché is that it's made with materials that you have in your house. You can do just about anything your imagination can come up with. You could make octopus, you could make birds, you could make giraffes, you could make elephants, you could whatever. Hi everyone, welcome to the Artery. This is our kids learning space, kind of a maker space, and we do art classes and all kinds of fun creating things here. This is Edwin Hu, he's one of my students, and he's gonna help me with our project for today. We're gonna be making some papier-mâché, and papier-mâché is a really messy project, but also a really fun project. And I like it because it's something you can do at home with materials you have at home. So all you really need to do papier-mâché is some flour, some water, a little bit of salt, and some measuring cups and a whisk, and a bin just so we can mix it all up in. You also need some newspaper that we're gonna cut up into strips. So that we can dip it into the papier-mâché. Also, some old cardboard boxes. Could be a cereal box, or a soda box, or brownie box, or whatever, because we're gonna use this to make the fin. Today we're gonna be making fish. And I'm gonna be starting my fish on a balloon. But Edwin is gonna be starting his fish by just crumpling paper and using masking tape to get his body shape. Edwin wants to make what do you wanna make?
A
salmon, right. And I think I'm just gonna make an imaginary fun fish. Okay, so I'm gonna start with blowing up my balloon, and Edwin, you're gonna start by showing him how to make your body, right? Here's some newspaper. I know, right? And here's your tape. So how are you gonna do that, Edwin? So as you can see, there's no steadfast rules to making the shape that you want. It's up to your imagination. And there's a million different ways to do it. The way that you mix the papier-mâché is a 2-to-1 ratio. So we're gonna use 2 cups of water to 1 cup of flour. And what else?
And if you double the recipe, you'll get 4 cups of water and 2 cups of flour.
Correct, and a dash of salt. So 2 dashes of salt. One.
Hey, it's sticking.
That's all right. We'll put extra on this one. 2. There you go. You soak it in there?
Soak it in there, and then you make it so it's drier.
You remember what the name of a king salmon is?
Chinook.
Chinook, right?
Yeah.
Your strips little, and crisscross them.
As we said, we were gonna get messy.
So we finished our fish. It was a lot of messy fun. A lot of mess, huh?
Yeah.
A lot of ooey gooey stuff, but we're gonna let them dry, and we propped some stuff underneath the fins so they don't sag, and under the tail on that one, and we're just gonna let them dry like that. At this point, if you wanted to, you could open up a paper clip if you wanted to hang your fish in the future, and you could take the strips and go right over top of a paper clip, and it gives it kind of like a little hook that you can hang your fish from. Well, fragile right now. That's looking like a salmon though. Put a primer coat on it, like you're gonna paint on walls. It is a coat that you put on first so that when you put the color on, it's brighter. So usually primers are white. So you can use a gesso if you have it. If not, you can just use any kind of white acrylic paint, even white house paint, whatever you might have. Not watercolor, that's not gonna work the best. So we're just gonna use an acrylic white. These are a really great trick for art teachers. These are the little cups you get them at Walmart or at the grocery store, and they have lids, and they're just meant for condiments. In here, and that way when there's leftover paint, and there always is leftover paint, you don't waste it. After you get it all painted in its primer, you let it dry, and then you can go and paint it any magnificent way that you want. You could paint it with polka dots or stripes or scales. You can use Sharpie to add detail. You can use metallic Sharpie on the fins to make fin lines. You could do all kinds of things. The brains that children have are unparalleled. They aren't afraid. Their imaginations go every which direction. They have so much to pull from. You know, we kind of lose it as adults. Kids are raw, and that's what makes it amazing.